Knock, knock!
I love this thing.
Hello everyone and welcome. Today we answer the question, can you beat Elden Ring with only the One-Eyed Shield's Flame Spit? So you're all probably wondering, how exactly am I going to get this weapon considering it's all the way in the mountaintops of the Giants, an area that isn't accessible until halfway through the game? Well, you see, if you stand in this exact spot and then pause the game and input up, up, down, down, left, right, left, install cheat engine, you can be gifted the One-Eyed Shield. I know I'm going to get comments about how I cheated it in because, well, I did. But my only other options were to either have a friend drop it for me, which would require having friends, or do the whole run a new game plus, and I didn't really want to do that because of balancing issues. Anyway, now that I have the weapon, it's time to try it out. Oh, Jeff! Ah, that's right. Can't use the Ash of War if you can't use the weapon. Well, alright, that's not so bad. How much strength do I need to wield it? 36. And how much do I have? 16. Awesome. Okay, it's not actually that big of a deal because while I literally just said 36 strength, that's to one-handed. To two-handed, I only need 24, which can be obtained temporarily with the strength not crystal tier. So now let's try this bad boy out. That's pretty satisfying. I already know what issues I'm gonna have in this run, but I don't care. Big explosions make me big happy. You know what? I'm feeling super confident. I'm gonna head straight to Margit. Ah, so that was a mistake then. Well, my confidence was short-lived, so let's talk about the issues with this weapon because there's more bad than good. First, just like the ballista, it's so slow. It takes 1.5 seconds to wind this thing up, and I know that doesn't sound like a lot, but trust me, it is. When I do fire it, it takes a pretty decent chunk of mana and a decently pretty chunk of stamina. As in, currently, each shot drains my whole bar. So, after I fire it, I'm basically defenseless. Which sucks extra hard because enemies will react aggressively to flame spit being shot at them. So if the attack doesn't knock the enemy down, which it won't for like 97-ish percent of bosses, I will get a face full of sword. Lastly, flame spit doesn't scale with any stats, so the only way to get extra damage is to level up the weapon. In other words, this is not a great decision, but whatever. After a little cave diving, I can bring the shield up to a +1, then give myself 19 strength, that way I can use Radagon's Sword Seal instead of the strength not tier. Margit, I have come back to show you that you have not yet put my foolish ambitions to rest. Oh come on man, that would have been such a cool way to end the fight. I can't have nothing. Whatever, he goes down in a much less cool way a few seconds later. So this is normally where I would say something something Stormveil, blah blah Godric easy, and I definitely will say that, just not right now. Instead, I head over to Summon Water Village for the Green Turtle Talisman, then to Kaelid to live out my dreams of being an artillery cannon. This putrid avatar is insanely weak to fire and will drop the Flame Shroud and Crack tier. I know I said leveling the weapon is the only way to increase damage, but that was only half true. Damage buffs still work. Now it's back to the castle. Something something Stormveil, blah blah Godric easy. See, I said I would say it. This early in the game, it's pretty easy for me to outpace anything in terms of damage, but I've done enough challenge runs to know that isn't gonna last. So the first thing I do in Liurnia is visit EG and make my shield a +4, then I collect that area's seeds and tears. Well that's unfortunate. I mean, first try, never fail, master of video games. Doing things a little out of my normal order because I'm terrified of Rennala, I want to pay a visit to Ronnie. I hate this game. Yeah, I learned right here that some enemies can avoid my attack by doing absolutely nothing. Loretta is even more annoying because at my current vigor, she can actually two-shot me with a combo I can't get out of. But she can be staggered out of an animation if she gets hit, which sounds like a great thing, except when she just immediately decides to do a second attack while I'm still in the end lag of mine. That being said, this stagger is actually the key to success. All you have to do is make sure there's enough distance between you and her and she can't really do anything about it. It takes me way more tries than I'd like to admit, but eventually she goes down. Ronnie, good to see you. I haven't slaughtered your whole family or beaten up your mom yet, so this isn't awkward yet. Right? 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 Okay, the real reason I actually started Ronnie's quest so early is because now I can buy the Carrion Filigreed Crest, reducing the FP cost of skills. Less FP, more explosions. Up next is the Academy, and this is probably the worst Red Wolf of Radagon fight I have ever had as I kept getting hit by painfully obvious attacks that I've dodged hundreds of times before, but none of that really matters when you can just four-shot the boss, I guess. You know, it would probably be smart to deal with Moongrum, just in case I have to do the run back. Never mind, if you ignore the problem, it just sorts itself out, I guess. I wasn't sure how well Rennala was going to go, considering right now I can only fire 4 shots per mana bar and 3 of those are dedicated to her sweetings. When her shield finally does break, I do good damage, but I'm taking a lot of chip damage as the load time is so slow the sweetings books are constantly smacking me in the face. Also, Rennala fires tombstones. I forgot about that. Fight's usually over before she even gets a chance. So she's definitely doable right now, but I wanted my shield to have a little more oomph, so I head to Altus Plateau. Here I grab the Fire Scorpion Charm, artillery this Scarab for a somber 5, then take the 6 from this kind man in a chair. I wanted to go all the way to plus 10 honestly, but I didn't know where the cool kid speedrunners get the plus 7. I only know of the bridge jump in Volcano Manor, which has been made way harder since the game came out. I spent an hour trying to do this jump, but I just could not get it. I also tried to do the Godskin Noble skip by jumping around these pillars, which is much easier as I was able to get the first pillar in about 10 tries, but then immediately failed on the second one. Can anyone tell me in the comments below which plus 7 Somberstone speedrunners get, because I'd love to know. Anyway, I make my shield a plus 6, then take on the Moon Queen again. Fortunately, phase 2 is easier because... That being said, I still got greedy and the game never misses a chance to humble me. On the next attempt though, she takes our flaming hot shots to the face and goes down. Next up is General Radahn, and I'll be completely honest, I was terrified of this fight. He has some really big openings, but I don't know if they're that big. But whoever said the best offense is a good defense is absolutely right. I was able to find 3 openings. The first is his crawling attack. As long as you're right up next to him, he just misses the whole combo. The next kind of obvious one is his gravity slam. Pretty much everyone knows about that. The last one, however, is his flying corkscrew attack, which I did not expect. You can literally just run out of the way of the first dive and then stand there and the second hitbox won't reach you. Oh, and you can also fire at him when he summons meteors, but that's few and far between. And with that, General Radahn goes down on the second try. Oh crap, I forgot about my mana. Radahn, stop! I'm not trying to throw for content, please! Oh come on, that would have been a great shot. Why do you have to rip me off, game? Again? Well, whatever. He winds up with a gravity explosion sealing his fate. Internet, I'm gonna need you to avert your eyes. Whoa, the warrior jar shard. Where did that come from? Down into Nokron, I fight the most tenacious boss there is. Why hunt with bow when you can hunt with bomb? Grabbing the Finger Slayer blade, I take it back to Princess Moonblast over here, that way I can lob fireballs at this hanging falling star beast thing. Wow, I sure do hope the real Estelle is this easy. Anyway, the reason I do that now is because it drops the Somber 7, then I can get the 8 and 9 from Dragon Barrow, do Varya's quest to get to Mogwen Palace for the Ancient Somberstone, and bam, a plus 10 one-eyed shield. I think my first test of this weapon will be the Regal Ancestor Spirit. A lot of you have noticed that I complain about Bambi in every video I do. Well, there's a reason for that. Because he's a disappointment every time I see him. I mean, I literally 3-shot the boss. I don't care if it's because I have a plus 10 shield, that's just bad, Bambi. Do better. Continuing the tradition of putting off possibly hard boss fights for much easier ones, I make my way through the Rot Swamp and face off against Estelle. This fight was going great, right up until his grab hitbox decided I just don't get to live anymore, so that's cool. I'm sorry, did that fireball just curve towards you? I don't know if that's because of the gravity magic or not, but that's cool, I've never seen that before. Anyway, Estelle goes down on the second try. Similar to Radahn, I thought the Demon Lorax would be a problem, but turns out he's a pushover. As long as I was far enough away from him after the stagger, nothing he could do was fast enough to hit me, though I will admit there was probably a little bit of luck involved in him never following up with a fireball. Oh well, his loss. We blow up the Trumpet Boy, as is tradition in Lindell Bandcamp, but before fighting Godfrey, I wanted to grab Margit's Shackle, figuring I'd need it. Bro, I'm not so sure a frontal assault is the play. Seriously, this is a bad idea. I'm warning you. Well, I warned him. Alright, Patches has to be immune to being one-shot. There is no way he is that lucky. Anyway, with Shackle in hand, I fight everyone's favorite golden boy. Surprise, completely easy. Literally just run away from him and fire from across the arena. With 4 talisman slots in hand, I head back to the Lux Ruins where... Jesus Christ, this thing is ridiculous. Morgott is up next, and I had planned on trying to figure out what openings were safe, develop a strategy, use the shackle, and win, but on my first try, I kinda just unga-bunga'd my way through it. Like, we were trading blows, which normally isn't great because, you know, if hurt many times, then die real soon, but the damage I do is absolutely bonkers and it doesn't matter. Also, glad to know I wasted 5,000 runes on a shackle, but whatever. My happiness with how much damage I was doing was short-lived because now I have to fight the Fire Giant. Phase 1 is admittedly pretty easy, just stay under him and there isn't much he can do, even after he breaks out the counterfire. Phase 2, well, things get a bit trickier. Hitting his weak points are a must in order to have enough attacks to actually win, and as far as I could tell, there were only 2 attacks that had a big enough window to safely attack. The Double Arm Slam and the People's Elbow. For the double arm slam, it's actually better to just shoot at the top of his head, and for the elbow, if you're in a good spot, you can try and hit the eye, but the top of the head works here too. With patience and a whole liter's worth of blue Gatorade, you can slowly whittle down his HP and eventually die to this stupid fire attack. God, I hate it so much. Come on, give me the people's elbow.
Not like that.
There's definitely a you'll shoot your eye out joke in here somewhere, but I can't be bothered. So instead, let's take it straight to the Godskin duo. The hardest part about this fight is actually the very beginning because there's no broken pillars, but once the noble gets pushed into phase 2, you can literally just stand behind one and blast him with fireballs. That's it. That's the whole fight. Near the end, I ended up hitting both of them with one shot, which sounds like a good thing, but it actually means that they're both going to be moving aggressively, and that isn't fun. But since the fight was almost over, it didn't really matter. Pushing Vigor all the way to 70, I think it's finally time to start putting levels into mind. This whole 4 shots of mana bar thing isn't cutting it.
That will never get old.
Okay, Malekith, my normal strategy of bait the dagger drag doesn't work here, and everything else he does is too fast. I tried just firing around the corner, but that required a little bit of RNG for him to actually walk into the blast. To be honest, I thought this was going to be an instance of needing to face tank phase 1 and properly do phase 2, but then I found the answer. For some reason, when he would throw his rock at me, it would just fall short. Hey, editing Doom here. After watching back the footage, I realized I was actually readying the attack before he starts the rock throw as opposed to reacting to it. The reason being is that if you run away from him and he decides to just walk towards you passively, you're able to get a shot off and he can't catch up to retaliate in time. So that's what I was actually trying to do, but I still have no clue why the rock just didn't hit me. Anyway, for those of you out there that want to try this, just a heads up that this might not actually be as safe as I think it is. Anyway, back to you, scriptwriting Doom. Phase 2 Malekith is largely the same as when I fought him with a ballista. It's still possible to duck under his sword, but because the character doesn't hunch over to reload, the timing is a lot more strict. That being said, it was pretty consistent that if I fired after his acrobatics display, he just wouldn't run up to me. I don't know why, really, this attack isn't safe in any other run. Beastman over here was definitely the most involved fight up until now, but he too falls before the might that is Flame Spit. Gideon, I've had it about up to here with your crap talking. This is such a dumb way to fight, and I love it. He thinks he's gonna make an anime comeback, but I got news for him. Fireball beats Kamehameha. Mr. Lord here is pretty easy. Well, the first phase is at least. Similar to the other encounter, the strategy is just run away and hit him from afar. Phase 2 I didn't actually find a safe attack to punish. There might be one when he does his stomp first followed by the swing, but that attack is incredibly rare for me, so I didn't get a chance to try. Instead, I opted to just unga bunga him, considering he only needed 2 more attacks to phase transition. Horalu, on the other hand, proved to be a little bit more interesting of a fight. My first thought was to try and punish the longer grab attacks, but the fire rate is just so slow you can't do it. Then I had a crazy idea. What if I let him scream in my face? He does this roar that knocks the player back, dealing no damage, but more importantly, staggers me out of my reload animation. For those of you that haven't had to study his moveset for some dumb challenge, he actually cycles these roars, with every other one being followed up by the Earth Shatter attack, but it doesn't actually matter in this case because we can get away from either of them. So yeah, that was the strat. Raiding my weapon anytime we can, and if he screams in my face, fire and then he'll knock me back. Oh no, roar, dang it. Oh actually, wait, that would have been a really cool shot. Do it again!
Game, please!
I choked many times while playing this game, so you'd think I'd learned my lesson and wait for an opening, but as a friend of mine once said, greed is key. Climbing the stairs, I face my destiny, Radagon of the Golden Order. This thing does the chunky damage, but when do I hit him? The only guaranteed safe attacks are right when the fight starts and when he does his 3 hammer slam. The only other sort of safe option is when he does this little hammer drag, but not the combo one, the one where he does it from a standstill. But since this thing hits like the force of a billion suns exploding, the fight's over before I even get a chance to look for any more openings. Elden Beast, on the other hand, has many openings. The massive stab, the 4 holy sword swings, and his dive bomb attack all allow ample time to retaliate. The bigger issue is making sure you have enough mana to get through the fight, but I ended up with like 3 backup blue flasks, so nah, Elden Beast is just easy. With that, I have beaten Elden Ring with only the Flame Spit Ash of War. What's that? You want to see the optional bosses too? Yeah, I was afraid you'd say that. There's one, well, technically 2 bosses I'm worried about, so I head to the sewer to confirm my suspicion. Yep, that sucks. So Mogear is 80% resistant to fire. I don't know why he's 80% resistant to fire. I mean, what is it about him that makes him so fireproof? Is his cloak made out of that silver blanket thing we all have in the glove compartments of our car? This is the same issue I had in my Madness Only run. I won't go into a math lecture this time, but it took me 35 shots to take him down. And this isn't even his final form. Literally. I guess that's a problem for future me to worry about. Man, I sure wouldn't want to be that guy. Fia's champions? More like Fia's... losers? Yeah, that was a good... burn. Unfortunately, I now have to stop having fun and do a little fetch quest. Like, okay, I get that this is important for lore and it develops Ronnie's and Fia's quests, but like, I hate having to run to get the Curse Mark of Death just to fight Fortisax. Oh well, at least he's easy. Like, really easy. Near the end of the fight, I landed a headshot that dealt a staggering 3600 damage. Well, that's cool. With one dragon down, I decided might as well do the next. Get over here, you big two-fifths of Hydra-looking dragon. I was not worried about Placidusax. I mean, I always complain how big and slow he is, and that definitely plays to my strengths here. There were no cool strategies, it was literally just bait a fire attack and, well, fight fire with fire, I guess. I was, however, a tiny bit worried about Commander Nile. I just couldn't picture when I'd have an opportunity to attack. He is like medium speed and a lot of his moves are big AoE attacks in some capacity, so I feared it would be hard. Until I found the amazing strategy of run away and shoot from distance. That seems to be a theme in this challenge. It also helped that at some point I started leveling endurance so it no longer eats my entire stamina bar to fire a single shot. Moving right along, next is Loretta. Now, I haven't forgotten that the shots fly over her head, so by free aiming and making sure to time my shots to stagger her at a distance, she goes down easy. But next up is Melania, Blade of Mikala. I'm sure a lot of you were looking forward to my pain here. I mean, she's quick, she's able to dodge attacks, and she can just delete my health bar if I'm ever standing still, which if you haven't noticed is basically my whole method of attacking. Well, I'm here to tell you that Melania is in fact an absolute pushover. All you have to do is wait for this uppercut slash thing. When she starts to leap into the air, just tap the attack button and the fireball should hit her outstretched hand. The reason why this is great is because she can be knocked over, meaning even if she tries to retaliate with waterfowl, she's already far enough away and you're out of in lag. Phase 2 is... well, easier in some ways and hard in others. Harder because she's more aggressive, so you really have to be careful of your stamina management, but easier because she can do Scarlet Aeonia, which is at least 2 free hits, the second one of which can be timed to knock her down. I have to say, it is extremely satisfying that a boss known for being so difficult can be trivialized with explosions. Unfortunately, that is not true for the final two, Rykard and Moog. They both suck, so let's start with Rykard first. Yeah, it's not happening. I changed my mind, I would like to leave the arena, please. So unfortunately, I don't think it's possible to beat Rykard like this. He has 80% fire resistance and like 18 bajillion health, but he's a gimmick boss, so oh, look at that, the Serpent Hunter Spear. I actually thought about giving myself a cursed one-eyed shield with a Great Serpent Hunt Ash of War on it, but was feeling kinda lazy, so instead I decided I would only do this boss with L2 attacks. That might be disappointing to some of you, but probably not as disappointing as Moog. I got a lot of comments on my Frenzied Flame only video saying how I should have used Starlight Shards or the ugly Scarab headpiece, so let's just say right now that I'm aware of all these things I could do to change this fight, but trust me when I say, it doesn't really matter. And allow me to show you why. See how far away he is? In the amount of time it took me to Radius Shot and fire it, he was able to close that distance with his Bloody Thrust attack. He can also try to slam down with his Flying attack, which will throw blood pretty far by itself. In other words, he has attacks that can reach me while I'm still in the cooldown of my own. Normally I would resort to the Unga Bunga Trey blows and get a little lucky with him missing, but at 80% fire resistance, I just can't. I'm not going to do the math here either, but at a glance, I'm not entirely sure I have enough mana to properly finish the fight, so instead I decided, why not just beat him to death with the shield? I mean, it does pretty much the same damage and is decently slow. I also thought about trying to get him to jump into a corner and die from fall damage, but honestly this was more fun. And after a few dozen bonks, the challenge is over. Thank you everyone for watching, and an extra special thanks to my patrons. Stay beautiful, y'all. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving a like and subscribing. It helps the channel out way more than you know. And until next time, my friends, don't you dare go hollow.